In response to declining populations, the Wisconsin DNR initiated the Wisconsin Frog and Toad Survey to increase our knowledge of frog and toad abundance and distribution, as well as to monitor long-term population trends. The survey, initiated in 1981, is now one of the longest-running amphibian monitoring projects in North America. This long-term cooperative survey relies on volunteers who provide valuable information on the status of Wisconsin frog and toad populations. Learning the calls is the first step in volunteering for the Wisconsin Frog and Toad Survey. Accurate identification of frog and toad calls is imperative. The quality of the dataset depends on accurate reporting. Frog and toad identification videos are available on the website, and CDs or cassette tapes can be purchased from the Madison Audubon Society. Volunteers are given a route, or, in some cases, allowed to create their own. Contact the Bureau of Endangered Resources to see if a route is available or if it is possible to create a new route. Each route contains 10 roadside listening points. The route must be run 3 times per year within 3 designated survey periods. The timing of the survey with the phenology of frog calling is essential. Surveys are conducted in early spring, April 8th through April 30th, late spring, May 20th through June 5th, and summer, July 1st through July 15th. Routes are run after dark under favorable conditions. The wind speed must be less than 12 miles per hour, and it must not be raining steadily. If conditions deteriorate during a survey, the survey should be stopped, and the entire survey must be rerun on another day within the designated survey period. All 10 listening points on the route must be surveyed on the same evening. Approach a listening point as quietly as possible. The arrival of a car or a person on foot may cause the frogs to stop calling for a short time. Wait until the frogs begin calling again to begin the survey. Listen for 5 minutes at each site. Record all calls audible from the listening point on the data sheet. A call index value of 1 should be recorded if individuals could be counted and there was space between calls. A call index value of 1 would be recorded under bullfrog for the following. A call index value of 2 should be recorded if calls of individuals could be distinguished, but there was some overlapping of calls. A call index value of 2 would be recorded under cricket frog for the following. A call index value of 3 should be recorded if calls were constant, continuous, and overlapping. Individuals cannot be distinguished at this value. A call value of 3 would be recorded under chorus frog for the following. Do not, under any circumstances, walk onto private property without permission. Be sure that all data fields have been filled in. The data is not useful if the data sheet is not filled out completely. For more information about the Wisconsin Frog and Toad Survey, or to sign up for a route, please visit the website or email us at wfts@wisconsin.gov.